Hello friends, welcome to this new video in MongoDB tutorial video series. In this video, let us continue our discussion from previous video on MongoDB Compass and overview. In this video, I am going to share the part 2 of MongoDB Compass. Let me connect to MongoDB Compass localhost. It is trying to connect to MongoDB server running on my local machine. If you look at this, now on the left hand side we have already seen that it is the list of databases, and let me select one of the databases. Now I'm going to explain the schema part of a collection. Let me click on schema here, and as you can see that it gives me an option to explore schema. Now let me click on analyze schema, and it will start analyzing the schema here. At the top, as you can see, documents, number of indexes, which we saw in the previous video also. Here, if you look at this, that it has listed down the fields which are there in this video. Let me just close this left navigation, and you can see that this is the title of the field, and on the right hand side it is showing different values added over a period of time, right? So I can move to class results field, and it says that array of documents with 4 nested fields. So it is an array. Class results is an array with 4 nested fields, right? Let me just expand it, and you can see that class ID is the first field, which has values 81% of the values varying from 7, and then we have 8 values, and marks another field, right? Again, this is the distribution of marks. Then result, pass, fail, there are 2 values, and then we have year, which is 2020. All the values have 2020. Class ID is basically, there are 2 values for class ID. One is class ID 7, class ID 8. So for 7, 81% of the total records which are having class results, class ID field, are those records. Let us move to next field, name field, and you can see that it has listed down some of the values on the right hand side, and it is a string field. All the values correspond to this field are string, 100% string. Then moving to personal details, it is a document, and it has 3 nested fields. Let us again expand it. Age, which is double, email, string, mobile, again double. Age 17, we have 56% of the documents or students, because we are exploring students data here. 56% of the students are having age as 17, 18 and 19. You may notice that the sum of all these percentages would lead to 100, 56, 25 and 19. Same way, it has listed down emails and then mobile, right? Different values. Then remarks, it is a string, some values, right? And as you can see that only 13% of the documents are having remarks as value. Rest of the documents are not having value for remarks field. Same way, sports, right? It is a array, right? And minimum value 1, maximum 3, right? In that array, number of elements, I mean. Then status, active, suspend, inactive. So this is how basically schema can be explored using a graphical user interface of MongoDB Compass. So it is very impressive, and by now you might have evaluated or observed that this is very useful schema, profiling of the MongoDB data residing in the collection. So here we have only limited set of data, that is why it is showing like this. Let me now show you some other collection. Let us see places, analyze schema, and here we can see that there are three documents, right? And you can see that, let us see first document. These are the three documents. If I click on schema, it shows category as string, location as document, right? It has coordinates field, right? And then name. Now let us go to classes also once. Analyze schema. So here also, because we have limited number of documents, you can see that it is 75% of the documents have class ID as string, and 25% of the documents are having value as double, section and title. Let us see class ID field here, and as you can see that class ID is 7, which is numeric here, so that is why it was showing us 25%. Out of these four documents, one document is having numeric field, rest of the three documents are having value of class underscore ID as string. That is why 75% of the values are string and 25% is 1. So with this, I would like to end this video here, and I hope you have been liking my videos and you have liked this video as well. Please keep sharing my videos with your friends and colleagues. In the next video, I'm going to cover advanced feature of MongoDB Compass and MongoDB Atlas as well. Thank you so much for watching this video. See you in future videos. Thank you.